Hi my dear students, welcome back to Gurudeva online classes. Last class we was learnt about the topic of the synthetic fibers and plastics. Last class we was learnt introduction of the synthetic fibers and what is synthetic fibers and types of synthetic fibers, that was learnt in previous classes. Okay. What about the synthetic fiber? That is, you know that we wear the different fabrics. Fabrics are made from the fibers. Fibers are obtaining two sources, that is the natural sources and artificial sources. Natural sources is occurred in nature. Artificial sources is not occurred in the nature. Thus natural sources like cotton, jute, wool and silk, these are the natural sources. Artificial sources, these are not occurred in nature, this is the man-made sources, this is made by the chemical substances. Okay, these are natural artificial sources like rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic, these are the artificial sources, this is made by the chemical substances. Afterwards we was learnt what is synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber, this is the artificial sources, this is made by the units, small units. These small units together to form a large unit. Small units made by the chemical substances. These chemical substances to formation large unit, that large unit we can call it as the polymer. These words came from two Greek words, that is the poly and mer. Poly means many, mers means the unit or parts. It means many repeating units, that is called the polymer. Afterwards we was learnt two types of synthetic fibers, that is the rayon and nylon. Rayon, this is nothing but the artificial silk. Why we are called artificial silk? Because of the instead of silk, this looks like a silk fibers, and this is made by the chemical treatment of wood pulp. Wood pulp is a natural raw materials, but nylon is not made by the natural raw materials. This only used for making chemical substances, pure chemical substances. This nylon is a pure artificial substances. This is made by the pure chemicals. This is not used any natural raw materials. Today we are going to learn about the two types of the synthetic fiber, that is the polyesters and acrylic. These are the two types of synthetic fiber. Okay, that first we are learn about the polyester. You know that polyester, already we know that this is the artificial sources. These are made by the, this is made by the chemical substances. Which chemical substances to make a polyester? Observe here, the poly means many. This is the ester. Ester is a chemical substances. These ester, small units of ester to form a large unit, that large unit is called the polyester. It means repeating units to form a large one, that large is called the polyester. It means polyester is made by the one of the chemical substances, that is the ester. Okay, these polyester is one of the synthetic fiber, already we know that. You know these fabric, we are the different fabrics. Fabrics are made from the polyester fibers. That does not get any wrinkled. You know, these polyester cloths or polyester shirts does not get any wrinkled easily compared to another fibers. Next one, it remains crisp and easy to wash. You know, crisp means dry, you know, in suitable condition is always dry and easy to wash. This polyester cloths are easy to wash and crisp, and this does not get any wrinkled. You know, the most of the peoples are wearing the polyester shirts and other cloth materials. That cloth materials are comfortable and suitable for all condition. You know, this Terylene, you know, observe that Terylene is a popular polyester. This is the one of the popular type of the polyester. That these polyester having many more types. The Terylene is a popular polyester. You know, these Terylene is made by the one of the chemical substance terephthalate. That chemical substance is called the terephthalate. Terephthalate, small units of terephthalate substances to form a large unit to form a Terylene. This Terylene is made by the terephthalate. This Terylene, it can be, why we are uses the Terylene? Because of the, it can be drawn fine fibers, you know, the Terylene fibers drawn, that we get the fine fibers. That fine fibers are, can be woven like a another yarns, like a another yarns, because of the this Terylene cloth or Terylene polysters are we are users. Okay, that another form of the polyester, that is the PET. PET means polyethylene terephthalate. This is also one of the chemical substance. This is a form of the polyester. Okay, this form of the polyester is making, for making bottles, you know, we are uses the many more bottles. That bottles are made by the PET and utensil. We are uses the home utensils, household utensils, that is also made by the PET, and films also made by the PET, wires and other materials also made by the PET. You know, this is the PET is the one form of the polyester. This is the PET is made by the chemical substances. Okay, this is the polyester. Okay, next, this is the one type of the synthetic fibers. The next one type of the synthetic fiber, that is the acrylic. Acrylic is another one type of the synthetic fibers. You know, we are the shawls, towels and blankets in the winter season. We are always shawls and towels in the winter season. That many of these are actually is not made by the natural wool. You know, shawls and blanket, these are these are made by the natural wools, but that is not made by the natural wool. That these are prepared from the one of the synthetic fiber, that is called the acrylic. This acrylic is looks like a natural wool. You know, acrylic is nothing but the artificial wool. You know, this artificial wool looks like a natural wool. You know, this natural wool is quite expensive. You know, observe, we are uses the natural wool materials. That natural wool materials are quite expensive because of the, we are uses the acrylic materials. These acrylic materials are looks like a natural wool. You know, whereas cloths are made from the acrylic, relatively cheap. Observe that which fabrics are made by the acrylic substances, that is relatively cheap, you know, compared to the natural wool. You know, next, they are available in variety color. That wool, natural wool is made, not made by the natural wool, is not available in different color, but acrylic materials are cloths are available in variety colors. Different colors of acrylic materials or acrylic cloths are present in our markets. Okay, because of we are uses the acrylic cloths. Next, they are durable and affordable. These are durable, you know, we wear the long time. This acrylic cloths are wear the long time and affordable, you know, this reasonable prices available in the market. You know, acrylic cloths are reasonable prices is available in the market. Next one, you know, that these are the advantages of the synthetic fibers. So many advantages we learn. So many advantages is there in the synthetic fibers. You know, some disadvantages of synthetic fiber is also there. You know, synthetic fibers are melt easily. Melt on eating easily. Okay, this is the disadvantages of the synthetic fiber. Next, we will learn that characteristics of the synthetic fiber. Characteristics of the synthetic fiber. You know, this synthetic fiber is very useful to human beings because of the more characteristics, because these fibers are possess unique characters. Now, this is a make them very popular dress materials. We are different kinds of the dress materials that is made by the synthetic fibers. You know that polyester cloth, we wear the polyester cloths, acrylic, rayon, and so many nylon cloths also we are users. These synthetic fibers are very popular for making dresses. You know why we are chooses the synthetic fibers, synthetic fabrics, because of the these synthetic fibers or synthetic materials are dry up quickly, easily dry up, quickly dry up, and durable also, the long lasting and less expensive, and ready available in the market, and easy to maintain and easy to wash. Because of the we are choose the synthetic fibers or synthetic fabrics materials. Okay, today we was discussed two types of the synthetic fibers, that is the acrylic and polyester. Polyester, already you know that polyester, this is made by the ester units. It is made by the ester unit. Ester unit is the one of the chemical substances. Okay, next one, that acrylic. This acrylic is also one of the artificial substances. This is used for making shawls, towels, and blankets. Next one, characteristics of the synthetic fibers also learnt in these classes. That is, so many characteristics is there. Now, this useful to these are dry up quickly, durable, and less expensive, readily available in the market, and easy to maintain. Okay, next class we will learn that type of the plastics and plastic materials are choice, and plastic is non-reactive, and plastic is light, strong, and durable. It means characteristics of the plastic we will learn in next class. Thank you.